gentlemen, this is Skipping Scores on R2TV's Breakfast Show. My name is Adeoye Salem, and this morning I got two good people in the building. When I say two good people, I mean they're special. And when I say they're special, I mean they like to talk sports. First of all, I got my regular brother in the building, Mike.
Yep, it's great to be here.
I've never been able to call that his other name. That's his alibi.
Don't worry. Let's go to the next person. Don't worry. Just leave it at that.
And of course, I got my brother, the sounded master, the man who's got all the movement in the building. Hey, Glenn Mena, Baba.
Yes.
He got all them girls drooling when he came in this morning.
It's tall.
Did I do that?
Yeah. I like fine boys coming here on the show.
Fine boy will be a bit too much.
Now you've added too much to it.
Yeah, too much. Now.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, okay, we're here to talk sports. And straight on, Glenn is really, really eager. Of course, Sam. Yes. The biggest news this morning happens to be the Champions League. The Champions League opened yesterday. Champions League is back. And of course, as it is, on the opening day, 20 goals were scored. And of course, Real Madrid and Sevilla contributed to 7. Real Madrid 4, Sevilla 3. But the big one is that out of the 7, Cristiano Ronaldo actually got himself 3. Well, the argument is that he scored 2 from the penalty spot. But at least they counted it for him as an hat-trick. So he got the first hat-trick of this year's Champions League.
Yeah.
But then it's not about Real Madrid right now. It's about the fact that Manchester United fell flat to PSV Eindhoven.
Fell flat, I like that word.
Mm. What do you think about that match?
They're playing at a PSV, they're playing away.
I didn't watch it, I was following up. And I saw 1-1 with my manager.
Okay.
So I was like, 1-1, it's not bad. Let them just draw or lose. Because as an Arsenal fan... Arsenal fan, we're all very biased when it comes to issues like this.
Okay.
When it comes to Man U, Chelsea, Man City, Liverpool.
But I thought in the Champions League that we're united.
No,
yes,
united.
Because I think it's all the minors. England lost.
We are not.
Oh no, that's not fair, man. Both English teams lost yesterday. Wouldn't you feel somehow?
No, I wouldn't. If I win today, I won't feel somehow.
And then what if Chelsea loses? Yeah.
But okay, I'd like to bust your bubble. Arsene Wenger came out this morning, has been reported to say that look. We're not dreamers, that our hopes in the Champions League is... So Arsenal fans should just forget...
No. He always says that, though.
No, but last season he was hopeful, but now he's saying that, look...
He still always says that, technically.
Technically.
Yes, he always says that.
But he's not like a mind-game
person. So the fans don't get to hope too much. Do you get? But okay. he's going to deliver results, last.
This is a die-hard Arsenal fan.
Typical Arsenal, we will probably drop out at the quarter... second round, semi-final. Typical Arsenal. We cannot drop out at the first round.
Okay.
So you're sure of the second round ticket?
Yes, I am.
Okay. Well, let me just quickly run through the results. PSG, Paris Saint-Germain, defeated Malmo by 2-0. Of course, Edson Cavani was also on the score sheet. And of course, Angel Di Maria got his first PSG goal. Beautiful goal. I mean, it was almost at an impossible angle. And a lot of people thought, how did he score that? Left leg from the right wing. That's Angel Di Maria for you. Jay, you want to say something about that one?
I don't know what went wrong when he went to Manchester United. I don't know what went wrong.
I think he's a classic player. Yeah, he is. I think it was LVG. LVG can be hard to work with when it comes to status, man. He's just some... I mean, how can you explain loaning out Yan Zai and getting Martial? Martial is showing that he might be...
Exactly. We have to now consider the LVG factor. He scored on his debut, Martial. Good player. Yes,
yeah.
But...
So what is the LVG factor here now?
Man, Falcao is the LVG factor, man.
How do you mean?
Falcao is a world-class striker. But somehow he came into Manchester United and he didn't deliver.
Okay.
Di Maria is an LVG factor. He came into Manchester United. Good player. He has won almost everything in Spain. If he didn't win everything.
Yeah, definitely.
And he didn't deliver in Manchester United. That's two. It's not a mistake anymore.
And of course, David De Gea is having issues with him. Victor Valdez is having issues with him.
See, so I don't like talking football.
I wish they came to Arsenal.
That's not fun. They'll be playing with yourself in here.
Okay, now Rafa Benitez is particularly happy with himself. I mean, Real Madrid, they're on a roller coaster. Cristiano Ronaldo is scoring. Mike, do you have any objection?
No, okay. Rooney scored 50 goals, 28 penalties.
He scored 50 international goals.
International goals.
28 penalties.
28 international penalties.
Exactly. No, yes. 28 international penalties.
That's a record now.
I like that. But you see, for me, for Ronaldo, I see this factor like people would, I, yes, the team plays around him, but they play too much for him.
They play too much for him.
He scores a penalty and he goes like he has scored from his own post to the other post, man.
I don't think so.
What do you think?
Okay.
First time I saw Cristiano Ronaldo was Sporting Lisbon against Manchester United. What he did. And then he came into Manchester United. What he did. It was the first, after a very long time, as Arsenal fans, we're expecting Thierry Henry to get the world best. Yeah. He didn't get it. They said it's an English football factor.
Okay.
That Beckham was supposed to have it one time, but he didn't. That English players, they don't give it to them. But Ronaldo came and he got it.
And he got it.
Right in Manchester United. So we saw what he did. So please. He's exceptional.
VLF Wolfsburg defeated CSK Moscow by a lone goal, and then Benfica defeated FC Astana by 2-0. That FC Astana,
a very wonderful story, because that club was formed just 6 years ago.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Just 6 years ago, and they're already in Champions League. It's a story of, it's this kind of stories that make you feel good. Like, okay, yeah, even if they don't go out in the first round, but for the fact that a club that was formed
6 years ago.
6 years ago.
Shows that their progress.
Well, some clubs that have been formed, they didn't even make it to the Champions League.
Well, clubs like that, they've been there for...
Our time is really fast, Ben, but quickly now. Tonight is AS Roma versus Barcelona. Then we have Bayer Leverkusen versus Beit Borisov. And, of course, Dynamo Zagreb versus Arsenal, your darling club. If Arsenal should lose, Glenn, I know where to find you.
We can't lose now.
Olympiacos versus Bayern Munich, and of course, Chelsea versus Maccabi Tel Aviv, and then Dynamo Kiev versus FC Porto, and KA Ghent versus Lyon. Now, the big news for me here is the fact that Jose Mourinho had to actually call a pressman stupid and ask him to Google.
You know, at times they get agitated. It happens.
You know, the thing was about, a lot of people have been going on about Jose Mourinho's third season hoodoo, and he came out to say, like, look, what do you mean? In Porto, I never had a third season. In Inter, I never had a third season. And so he went on and on, and he said, look, if you don't have your facts, Google it. But then looking at it right now, do you think, someone also asked him, is he under pressure because he's prioritizing Champions League in favor of the league? And he said, no. We really do apologize for that break in transmission. Sometimes, sometimes some people just, because you're speaking against their club, they decided to go somewhere and cut
to sabotage.
And cut the wires and sabotage a lot of things. But you know what? Go past them. Go past them. Okay, well, quickly now, our time is fast, but like I said earlier. But let's look at the Champions League this year. For you, who and who are you seeing in the finals? Quickly, who and who are you seeing in the finals?
Without being patriotic. Just two clubs? I could just name two clubs.
Okay, let me name four.
Bayern Munich, Real Madrid, Barcelona. Let me just speak on from England, Arsenal Football Club.
Okay.
They will say I'm being patriotic. Really? But
at least you don't mention.
I would have said Manchester City, but after what happened yesterday, I'll just call Arsenal.
Mike, would you?
I'll just stick with Bayern and Barcelona. I don't know. Just stick with them. If I don't see Madrid doing.
No Real Madrid? No Real Madrid?
No, I don't see them. I don't see them going out. The team is just too self-centered, too centered around somebody. When the chips are down.
Isn't Barca centered around Lionel Messi?
No, really. Maybe. I don't think. He didn't play yesterday. He didn't play on the last league match. He came in and scored. But even before that, you saw what
he
Neymar
came in
did.
And scored.
So okay. See what Suarez did.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, my time is fast. But if I leave these two people, I know. Okay, Glenn, I'm going to use this opportunity to say that when the Champions League gets to the semi-finals or thereabout, I'm going to bring you on our sports show, Keeping Scores.
Yes.
And you are going to actually vet. And Mike, I'll try and make sure that on that day when Glenn is coming, you'll be there. Ladies and gentlemen, that's how much I can take this morning on R2 TV's Breakfast Show, Keeping Scores. Don't worry, you know where to find us. www.facebook.com/myR2TV. Twitter at R2_TV. Instagram at R2TV. And of course, WeChat at R2TV. Let's have your reaction. Don't forget the hashtag, Keeping Scores. My name is Adeoye Salem. I am your favorite peace samurai. And I say, enjoy the rest of your week. God bless ya.
So you know that if it's your favorite piece samurai, that means they're all that piece samurais.
Yeah, they're in the samurai clan.
Samurai clan. Okay. Then we get back on bloggers round. AGO will be back, and of course, hello.